So, after doing the Lonely Kitchen trilogy, you followed with Himitsu, the Top Secret, which is adapted by the immensely popular manga Himitsu. For you, like adapting material that is followed by hordes of really passionate fans, is it something that is a bit scary or something stimulating for you?
やっぱり新しいチャレンジですからね。あのジャンルも違うし、とても楽しみで楽しんでいますよ。
So, yeah, for me it is like a new challenge, so I enjoy to shoot that.
特にあの脳内映像をね、どういうふうに見せていくか、そしてどうやったら脳内映像を見ることができるのかっていうのを、3年ぐらいリサーチしましたね。
So, especially for the to show how to see inside of the brain, I researched for like 3 years to show that.
Yeah,
I started to research before Lonely Kenshin, part one, and so it's like from the beginning it is like 5 years.
So do you have questions? Est-ce que vous avez des questions?
Oui. Yes. It's one aspect of the movie. It's not part of the story, but just it's the fashion. Like for men and women, it's something I never actually see that you invented those kind of fashion, or something in Japan that's not out right now. Because there's the suits for men. I never saw that.
Yeah. Original is never experienced. Suit style. これは未来の話なので、suit style ってのは100年前から。
So yeah, we design all the suit in the film. The suit is something that is exists since like more than 100 years, but the fashion is changing all the time. So slightly. So we try to think about how the fashion will change in the future, the near future.
基本的な伝統的なラインは変わらないですよね、スーツの形はね。だからほんのちょっとだけ変わればあの彼が言ってくれたようになんかこう違和感の残る見たことのないものになるというか、それが未来未来感にこうつながるかなっていう。
Usually the suit doesn't change a lot, but if you change small details, you can change a little bit because the fashion doesn't change. But as you recognize that it was something a little strange, so. So it's not just the suit, but every details in the film was we made some research for that.
Is that why they choose to design the Department 9 like the Tokyo Hotel?
テーブルホテル、テーブルホテル。フランクロイド・ライト。いや、いうのだった。未来を作るときに、僕らは未来ではなくて。インペリアル。いやいや、インペリアルだと、いやいやいや。過去、日本のモダンの古いものにちょっとこう、遡って新しさを追求した。やっぱ日本に温故知新っていう言葉があるんだけど、わかる。古きを温めて新しくする。 古いものの中に新しさがあると思って、フランク・ロイド・ライトの建築を、ものすごくこう、今の僕らの時代から見ると、ものすごく新しくて、刺激的で斬新なんで、それをベースに作ったっていうことですね。
So yeah, we try to find the new thing in the old thing that we don't know. So we try to find in the architecture of Phantom of Light what could be a new thing. So we made something new from the old stuff.
It's okay.
Yes.
Were you thinking of a comparison between watching dead people's memories and watching film as a viewer?
あの、やっぱりその他人の経験を、まあ、このプロデュースとかに、小さい人の脳を覗くということは、他者の映画でもいいんですけど、他者のエモーションを覗くということでもあるので、まあ、そういう意味では映画を見るという行為も、誰かが作ったものを、そこで埋めてる登場人物たちのエモーションを共有するというか、お客さんが、脳を覗くという行為と映画を見る行為というのは、実は、あの、似通った行為じゃないかと思いながら作っています。
When I made this film, as you saw in the film, looking in the brain of someone is like to share the emotion, and that in the
other emotion,
the emotion of the other people. So the cinema also is the same kind of thing. You share the emotion of other people.
あの、これのパート2もそうですけどね、あの、ロールテンションの方ね、持ってるサインで。
Yes, it is important for this part two, but before, for the sequel of Ronnie Kenshin's, everybody are asking, so
busy.
And we have a lot of plans right now, so we are very busy. This film will be on screen in Japan from the 6th. And if there is a lot of success, the producer that is here will give some money. We can do some sequel.
It's up to you.
Actually, this is an adaptation from a manga that has been adapted in animation, and it's a very a work itself to adapt it its own live action. I wanted to know what were your references, since the complexity of this film, the films that inspired you, that you came to see along again, is it like, you know, in the 60s, or any films that were your influences that you wanted to see during your research?
映画は多分いっぱい見ていて、多分その僕は、どの作品って意識してないんですけども、多分、いろんな映画の影響はきっとあるんだろうなとは思います。ただ、リサーチしてる間は、映画の影響とか60年代、70年代、80年代、いろいろな時代の映画の影響というよりも、本当にどうやってね、脳内映像を、再現させていくか。 これも、なんかっていうのは本当にエモーションってエモーションの使い合いなので、まず脳の中をしっかりこう、映像として再現しないと、映画にならないんですよ、これ。脳がある意味主役の映画なので。それで、まあ、あとは、まあ、どうやってその、映画自体の中に、エモーションをね、僕のエモーションも含めて熱量が高い。熱量が高い。ね。 熱量の高い映画にしていかなきゃいけないと思っていたんですね。だからまあ、どのぐらいそのエネルギーをそういう文化を獲得に集中していたんで、あまりね、なんか自分で分析しないまま撮ってます。
So, when I was doing the research, I saw a lot of film, but I was not conscious which kind of influence I had. But what was important was to show how to show the inside of the brain. So I wanted to make something very passionate. So I didn't think a lot when I was doing which influence it can be, but I was thinking how to show the inside of the brain.
Okay. Thank you.
I was just curious which genre you prefer, whether it's sci-fi or movies about feudal Japan in terms of filmmaking, which you like better?
And for this film?
Yeah, like this is a sci-fi movie, but you also make movies about feudal Japan. So which style do you prefer making?
And do you prefer making? With relocation, okay. My opinion about relocation is very good. For us, I find it. Which one of you? I like to make both styles. Especially, I like to do what I never did before.
You seem to have fun with this one because there's elements of film noir, science fiction, and quite horrifying
moments.
So for you, it's something that it's important to try to do different genres, different type of universe.
Yeah. すごいたくさんジャンル見てるんで、やっぱり一つのジャンルに、多分新しいジャンルって今の時代認識しちゃうから、周りのような気がしていて、あまり決めつけてないですね、作る前に。だからフロントケンシも、アクションムービーって決めちゃうと、アクションムービーっていう扱いだけになっちゃうから、なんかこう、いろいろな、そのいろいろなジャンルの面白さっていうのが、そのつどこう、詰め込めればいいなと思っていて、今回ホラーの要素ももちろんあるし、ミステリーサスペンスでもあるし、スリラーでもあるし、 ただまあ深い深い人間のね深いこの魂のここまでもう入り込んでいるようなドラマでもあるし、そういう意味じゃそのジャンルをですね横断して作りたいと思っているところがあります。So
I think the new film we need to, there is some mixture of genre. For example, if you say that Ron Kenshin is an action movie, it's not exactly what it is. Of course, there is some aspect of action, but it's not the only thing inside. And for example, in this film, we have the horror part, the mystery, the thrill part, but also the human drama. So I like to go to mix and go from other genres.
ジョン・ルーがこの映画をすごく見てくれて、褒めてくれたんですね、すごく。それで、彼と僕ロサンゼルスで20年前にやってて、久しぶりに去年会って、ちょっといろんな話をご飯食べながらしたときに、すごく面白いなと思ったのは、やっぱりジョン・ルーさんの映画、僕すごい大好きで、80年代の初頭の香港ムービー、ここのファウンダーがそうでしょ、ね、っていう話をさっき聞いたんですけども、そうすると、 やっぱり女王が大切にしたのは、人物のエモーションだっていう話を聞いたんですね。だからアクションをやっていても、ただのアクションでは、人は感動しない。多分そこにアクションの中にエモーションがないと、多分見る人は心揺さぶられないんじゃないかと思っていて、だから全てのジャンルに、動く、そこで埋めている登場人物たちの エモーションをどうやってやってらせるかっていうことが一番大切という点で、ジョン・ウンさんとはすごくね、話がありました。So,
John Woo, who saw that film was very glad and liked a lot. With him, I met like 20 years ago in Los Angeles, and I love a lot of his films, and especially the film in the 80s. I was a fan, and here also people are Fantasia, like a fan of 80s Hong Kong movie and John Woo. And he's very, he put a lot of importance in the emotion of people, because he's doing action movie, but if it is just action, people are not moved. So it's important to put in the character the emotion, and that's also what I agree and I want to do.
The policeman's jaguar, do many policemen have jaguars, or did he still like to?
The car,
Yeah, but Manabe, he had a jaguar. So is that normal, or did he steal that like he stole the watch?
Why do you have a fixation on the jaguar?
It's a very fancy car, and I didn't think policemen had fancy expensive cars. Or in Japan they do?
Yeah.
So yeah, Manabe is like not a show, but he's like not in the police group. He's like more like outside. He does a lot of bad things under.
He takes bribes.
He has no house on the Jaguar. He has no house on the Jaguar. Yes.
Yes, hi. I love the film, by the way. I was wondering, after a comment you just mentioned, what kind of themes or what kind of genres you'd like to do next? Based on what you said, that you like to explore things you haven't explored before.
Well, next film, I have already finished. The title is Museum, science thriller, like a Seven thriller.
Like the film Seven.
The
film is ready and it is a bloody movie that will be screened in November, so next year I would like to bring it. And I finish also the next film I already shoot.
Japanese chess, shogi no shounen no seishun story desu.
It is a story of a young Japanese boy who do chess, and it is a story of a love story.
And
of course I have like a lot of few projects right now, so I would like to I want to challenge new topics.
Go see the trailer.
Thank you to stay until late today.
Another question?
I noticed in the movie Shiniko, she first had the cross and later she had that lock given by the serial killer. I don't know if it's in the original manga, but all the Catholic resources, is it your choice or it was in the manga?
It's my choice. Yeah. 1997 to 1999. For 2 years, I lived in LA. I lived in LA, Los Angeles, for 2 years. And
And I wanted to know more about the Catholic, the Christian culture, so I went often to the church.
So, yeah, って感じていたのはやっぱり宗教的なバックボーンっていうのが例えばセブンっていうのがまさに一番わかりやすいけど宗教的なバックボーンってやっぱり映画にすごくあるなと思っていてこの見てくれる
And also I realized that when you see you watch a movie here in North America there is a lot of backbone of reference of church and like, for example
Bible.
Bible and for example a good example is the film 7.
あの、日本人はだから日本は宗教を持ってないんですよね。特定のその今必ずあの日本の宗教と仏教も持っているといえば、いるだけど、こちらほど統一された宗教は多分ないと思うんですね。それで、これについて言うと、やっぱりその途中性で言ってるけど、やっぱり人の死者の方を除くっていう行為はどうですかね。神様との領域を犯すような行為だと僕はちょっと思っていたところがあって。<笑>
So yeah, and but in Japan, for example, there is not a very solid religious thing that is like general. Of course, there is the Buddhism, but it's not as solid as this. And also in the film, you use people are looking in the brain. And this is like playing with God. Playing with God. The act of looking in the brain is like playing, you play to be God. Playing God.
ある意味だから、やっぱり罪と罰を巡る物語だと思っていて、やっぱりそれで脚本を作っているうちに自然とですね、多分そのカトリックのような、モチーフっていうのが、
So yeah, like watching, making this film, it's like thinking about the faith and the punishment. So that's why I connected more like to the Christian culture.
Another question. Since this was an adaptation from a manga, and someone mentioned that there's an anime version of this. Did you took some of the visual language of the manga or the anime into the film?
Visual language.
基本的に僕ちょっと漫画の作品続いてるからその漫画をねどうやって映画化するのかとかどういろんな質問も聞かれるんですけども基本的に人物のキャラクターっていうのはすごく大事だとは思っていてただこれ漫画はやっぱり2次元で2ディメンションそれでやっぱ映像はそうではないもっと立体的生身の俳優が演じて汗もかくし走れば息も乱れるしやっぱりどんどんこう漫画のイメージで最初は作ろうと思うんだけれどもどんどんそこから卒業していくんですよねだからどうやってその早めにね漫画のイメージからこう卒業していけるかっていうことがちょっとしたポイントだと思っていて
So yeah, this is from a manga but manga is a world of two dimension and this is a three dimension the actor are like real They are sweating. If they run, they are very tired and they suffer a lot. So the point was to go out of the manga world. That was the important point. If you are too close to the image of the manga, you are not able to make something
like this.
But a good actor is like not just for they try to look like close to the character, not just from physically, but from inside, from the interior.
そういう意味では、あの漫画の僕自身も俳優だけじゃなくて監督としてもその作品を持ってるやっぱスピリットってあるんだな。なんかこう精神があって表面的に見せるのではなくて、本当この漫画はこれ次とまずってやっぱりテーマを持ってると思うんですよ。だからその漫画の中にもある大事なテーマを映画化するときに何が大切かっていうことを考えて、そのための準備をする。
And me as a director, I try to keep the most important spirit of the manga. Like for example, this one has like the faith and the punishment the thing. So I try to keep this part is very important. I try to keep it. Is it okay?
As is it your question?
Hi.
It's okay.
Domo arigato.
Interactive. One last question.
でもね、今日はあの近くにラジオヘッドがいるって聞いて、僕はこんなに人が集まってくれると思ってなかったんで、僕だってラジオヘッド行くもんね。なんかすごく嬉しいって言ってくれる。
Thank you very much.
しかもここまで来
て。Yeah, I was very glad today that you came because I knew that there were Radiohead playing just near, and if I was me, I would go to Radiohead. So. Thank you for staying so late for today.
Thank you.
Thank you.